Welcome to chemistry class. Here we are with the next part of the chapter number 6, metals and non-metals. We'll begin with the topic uses of metals. As metals have a wide range of applications in our day-to-day life, let us explore in this part of this chapter how metals are useful to us. So metals, if we see the history, then it dates back to more than 5000 years, and we were the first metal that we were able to use was copper, as copper was readily available in the free state. Followed by this, many other metals like gold, silver, aluminium and others were discovered. All these metals have been known since ancient time, and since the ancient time only we have been using them. You would be reading about how the various tools and all were developed and how they were used in history. You will read about that. If it is asked which is the metal which is most abundant in the earth crust, the answer you will write as aluminium. Put a note or put a mark under this line in your books and you will remember it is the most abundant metal in the earth crust. Answer is aluminium. So let us begin with the first metal being iron. Now we'll discuss some of the uses. So iron is tough, strong and inexpensive, and it is used here. So point number one, that it is used in the construction of the buildings. It is a strong metal, it has a high tensile strength, that is why it is able to bear heavy loads and thus used in the construction of the buildings. Iron bars are used there. Also it is used for making pipes, cylinders, machines, agricultural tools, mechanical tools, wire meshes, railings, furniture, etc. A wide range of applications are there just because iron is a strong metal. It is one of the strongest substances. It is not the strongest. It is one of the strongest substances of among the next one we'll see. Second use about it is to prevent the rusting of iron. How we can prevent? This is a shortage actually. We cannot say it is second point. It is actually a special point that is written because iron has a weakness also. It is very strong, but it is facing the problem of rusting. It can easily rust. So how we can prevent it? To prevent this rusting only, we can galvanize it. So galvanized iron is generally used to make pipe and sheets because they are more exposed to water and therefore rusting takes place on them. All details about rusting we'll see at the end of this video only. So hold on for now. Next, now iron coated with tin. If iron is coated with tin, then it is used to make cars. Next, non-stick utensils. They are also made of iron, but they are coated with a polymer. Polymer coating is there so that it can withstand high temperature. And because of that polymer, what will happen? Food will not stick there. That is why it is called as non-stick utensil. So these are certain uses of copper of iron. Now we'll move to the copper. That is the next one. So copper is a very good conductor of electricity next to silver. Silver is the best conductor, followed by copper. So it is the second in the case of electrical conductivity. Because of this ability to conduct electricity, it is used in the electrical wiring. Copper wires are there, copper cables are there, and even electronic gadgets are having copper metal because of the simple ability to be a good conductor of electricity. And being a good conductor of heat also, it is also used to make cooking vessels. Different vessels are also made of copper. So you would have also seen at your home in the kitchen, you can check copper utensils at the base. In some of the utensils, copper is present just because of the simple reason that it distributes heat faster. So two uses are there. First is it is used for making electrical wire, cable and gadgets. Second use is it is used for making cooking vessels. Next one, third one now is aluminium. It is also a good conductor of electricity and it is the third in the electrical conductivity. Just I told you, silver is the best conductor of the electricity, followed by copper, and the third one is actually aluminium. So copper and silver are costlier, aluminium is comparatively less costlier, and it is also very light weight, and because of that weight also we can make the wires of aluminium. Aluminium wires are much longer than those made of the copper. So aluminium is cheaper also, and therefore it is used on the roadside. The electrical wires, you can see, all of them are made up of aluminium only. We'll see these points now here. First is electric wires. Next point is about heat. Aluminium utensils are also there because it can conduct heat. Third one is given here, its lightness and malleability. Aluminium is so malleable that it can have easily it can be easily converted into foil papers. So it is used for making foils for packing food and the medicine wrappers. You can see all of them are metal only, made of metal, that is aluminium. So packaging of food and medicine is done in the aluminium foil only. Next, being lightweight, it is also used in aircraft. The aircraft body also contains aluminium metal. Next one, aluminium paint is there. Aluminium paint, what is the use of this paint? Aluminium paint is used on the iron objects to prevent rusting, because iron will rust. So on the iron object, we will use aluminium paint, and this will separate the iron from the outside atmosphere, and therefore rusting can be prevented. Next, we'll see the metal is magnesium. It is burning with a dazzling white flame. You can see in the photograph given here. So this is a cracker that is burning. So like this cracker also contains that same magnesium only. So that is, magnesium is present in the fireworks, in the crackers used on Diwali, and also it is present in the flash bulbs. So both are producing what? Both are producing white light, dazzling white light, because of the metal, that is magnesium. Whenever magnesium will burn, you will be able to see a dazzling white light, as you can see in this photograph. Next is, magnesium prevents rusting when it is coated over iron. So collars and cap of the magnesium are used in underground pipes. Underground pipes may have rusting because water is flowing in the pipes. So therefore, collars and caps of magnesium are generally provided on these pipes, on the underground pipes, to prevent the rusting. Next one, now zinc. It is used to galvanize iron. Galvanization of iron is done by the zinc, and also zinc is present in the dry cells. Followed by this, the next one is mercury. It is the only liquid metal which is known, and being a liquid metal, it is present in the thermometer, because it does not stick to the glass. It is used in making thermometers. Mercury is a good conductor of heat, and on heating or on cooling, it will expand and contract. That is why if it is used in the thermometer, it can easily tell our, it can easily indicate our body temperature. It is used in the thermometers. Next one, also another use, because it is not sticky, so therefore it is also used in making barometers. Barometers are used to check the atmospheric pressure, the pressure of the air on the earth's crust or wherever the person is standing. It can be in a plain area, it can be in the uphills in the mountains, or it can be the coastal area. Whatever the air pressure, it can be easily measured by the barometers. Barometers also contain mercury metal. Next is, large quantities of mercury are required in the manufacture of alkalis. Alkalis are basic substances that are bases. Opposite of acid are bases. So what are those bases? Like sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide. All these alkalis or all these chemicals are prepared by using mercury. Large quantities of mercury are required. Next is, it is also used in making amalgam. Mercury is used in the preparation of amalgams. Amalgams are what? They are the alloys of mercury. Like if you mix Hg, Hg is mercury only, symbol of mercury is Hg. So if you mix mercury with another metal, that is a silver, if that is silver is Ag. So if we mix mercury and silver, then both of them will produce an amalgam. And where this silver amalgam is used? In the cavities of the teeth. It is used by the dentist to fill that cavity. Another thing that we can use with this mercury is, we can use tin amalgam, SN, that is tin, symbol of tin is SN. We can use silver, in place of silver we can use tin. Both options are there. So if you mix mercury with tin, it is also called as an amalgam. The name is given tin amalgam. Tin amalgam also used by the dentists, that is cheaper one. The people who cannot afford more expenditure, they will be able to get the tin amalgam in their cavities in the teeth. Tin amalgam is filled. So that is different amalgams. I have given the example, you have seen in the previous video about that. Next, now lead. Lead is another metal. It is flexible and not at all that much reactive. It is not more reactive, and also corrosion resistant. Resistant means rusting will not take place. So in this case, because of the rusting is not happening, lead pipes were used earlier days. Lead pipes were used in place of iron pipes. People started using lead pipes because iron will rust and pipe will be destroyed after some time. So therefore, lead pipes were very much common for in the plumbing, in the connecting of the water pipes in the home, laboratory and all. But now it is not recommended. It is not at all advised. Why it is not advised? Because when water is flowing in that lead pipe, what will happen? Lead will dissolve in water. It will form lead hydroxide. And that water, when you are drinking, when you are using in your home, this lead will affect your body like a poison. That is, metal is poisonous. This lead metal is poisonous. It its use has been discontinued. Today's world does not use the lead metal pipes. Lead pipes are not used now. Earlier they were used. But what is the reason? Because lead, if it is used for making the pipe, then whatever water is flowing in that pipe will get mixed with lead. Lead hydroxide will enter our body and work as a poison. Some people become sick and ultimately they can die also. So at present, this metal is put to any other use which does not give any direct contact with our body because it is a poisonous metal. So where we will use it, first one is it is used in the storage batteries. In the inverter batteries, you can see lead metal is present. So the batteries which are rechargeable give a steady voltage. That is inverter batteries only, they are having lead, they are made of lead. Lead sheets are also used in the walls, floor and ceiling for deadening the sound in the soundproof studio. In the music studios where the songs are recorded, there only, so that echo is not coming, the sound is not echoing. For that only, lead sheets are present in the wall, floor and ceiling. As a result of that, that person who is performing the song, his voice will not have an echo and proper music can be recorded. Next is, it is used for shielding against the x-rays. Whenever the x-ray is done, the remaining part of the body, the person who is to be evaluated, whose x-ray is to be performed, that person is placed after a sheet that is made up of lead metal only, that is allowing proper x-rays to be done. Next, another example is given of an alloy which contains lead. So if tin is mixed with lead, it is an alloy, two metals are mixing. So this name of this metal is, of this alloy, is called as solder. Tin plus lead, tin, that is SN, plus lead, that is PB. Lead symbol is PB. It will give what? It will give solder, SOLDER. Solder is what? Solder is an alloy. Tin, SN, lead is PB, it will give solder. And solder is what? Solder is an alloy. So I hope it is clear. So this is solder. And the next one will come here. Short lead also is there. Short lead is present in the bullets of the guns. They are also made of lead. And it is an alloy of lead, arsenic and antimony. Three metals are present in the bullet. That is an alloy of all these things. So lead is also there. Next one we'll see, silver is a shining white metal. It is used where? First one is in the jewelry. Second one in the silvering mirror. The background of that mirror is having silver. Next, now For electroplating also it is done. On various objects made of different metals, like iron object, can be electroplated with silver. So only the outer covering will be looking of silver. It will give a silvery look. Actually the metal is not made of silver, still it will look like silver. That is what is done by electroplating. Also silver is present in Ayurvedic and Yunani medicines. Finally, silver foils, they are present where? They are present on the decorating of the sweets. They are used by the sweet shop owners for decorating their sweets, and we can easily eat them. Silver is not at all harmful to our body. It is good for our body. That is why it is present in Ayurvedic medicines and Yunani medicines also. Next one is gold metal. Is known for the yellow sheen and nobility. It is a precious metal, very costly metal, and mainly used in jewelry. Also it is present in Ayurvedic and Yunani medicines. Finally, it is also used for electroplating silver and bronze jewelry. Silver jewelry and bronze jewelry can be electroplated. A coating of gold can be done on silver jewelry. Then the silver article will look like gold only. Actually it is made of silver or bronze. That particular item will look like gold only. Next, the final one is platinum. It is a strong metal. It is a shining white metal, nobler, and it is more costlier than gold, one of the costliest metal, and it is mainly used in the jewelry only. Second one, it is used in many scientific experiments. So we have covered various metals and their uses. We will now move to the topic of corrosion. What is corrosion? That is rusting. Well, we have seen the properties of the metal. In that properties, we have seen the metals are having luster. The freshly cut surfaces of the metal are shining. But when they are exposed to the air, then what will happen? The surface will get tarnished. The color will change. That is called as tarnishing. Why this tarnishing is happening? Why the color is changing? It is happening because a thin film of that metal oxide is forming. On that metal, oxygen gas will react. Oxygen gas of the air will react, and metal will on reacting with oxygen will produce metal oxide. So a thin film, a thin layer of metal oxide will deposit there. Suppose this is a metal object. and it is present in a room. Oxygen of the room will react with this metal. What will happen? On the outer part of this metal, a separate layer will deposit. Inside metal will not be affected. Only the outer part of this metal will change into what? It will be metal oxide. This metal oxide, because on that metal a new layer has been deposited, that is why the shining of this metal will reduce. That is, the discoloration will happen, and this is what is called as tarnishing. Metal has been tarnished. You would have seen, like silver object, if you purchase, after some time it turns black. Why it has happened? Because silver react with oxygen and produce silver oxide, which is black in color. So that is tarnishing of silver. Similarly, sometimes what is happening, the hydrogen sulfide gas, it is present in the polluted air. It causes the formation of metal sulfide also. Like oxygen produces metal oxide, hydrogen sulfide will produce metal sulfide also. So that is why we can say, like here it is written, example, silver gas in polluted air by the formation of silver sulfide, and silver object, silver jewelry will turn black in color. So that is just because of tarnishing. We can rub that metal, we can do by using a cloth and all, you can clean that metal, again it will start shining. In many cases, example, silver and gold tarnishing protect the rest of the metal from the chemical action of the air. Tarnishing is good also in some cases, but if tarnishing is done for a long period of time, if the chemical action of the air is prolonged beyond tarnishing, then the compound are slowly eaten away and it is said to be corroded. So let us read this. What is corrosion? It is the slow destruction of the metal or an alloy by chemical action. Chemical action of what? Of the air. Of the air only. And in the case of iron, this corrosion is called as rusting. It is a common name of corrosion of iron is called as rusting. So in the case of other metals also, corrosion will take place, but there we will not speak rusting. Magnesium, aluminium, zinc, tin, copper, all these are having corrosion. But in iron, if that corrosion is happening, we have a separate name. It is called as rusting. In case of copper, you see this example is given. The corrosion of the copper is commonly observed in the kitchen. That is, if you use a copper utensil, it will have a green layer, a green color deposit on that. If you keep some water in that copper utensil, you'll be able to see green deposit there. And this green deposit is what? It contains copper sulfate or copper carbonate. If you wash that utensil again properly, rub it with a sponge or you can use a cloth or anything, it will be cleaned and again you can see the original reddish color of the copper back. So that is how corrosion is happening. What are the factors that are affecting here? First factor here, that is presence of impurities. If the pure metal is kept in isolation, separate, isolation means separately, without any disturbance, then the pure metal do not corrode. If any impurity is there in the metal, then it will corrode. Example of this thing, iron pillar at Delhi. It is near Qutub Minar only. It is standing in the open air, but still no chemical action has been done. There is a lot of pollution there. In Delhi, it is highly polluted. But still this polluted air is not affecting the iron pillar. Why is it so? Because it is made up of pure iron. Iron pillar has not corroded for centuries, for hundreds of years it is there. It is not corroded because it is made up of pure iron. Next is the presence, that is water vapor. If water vapor H2O is present in the air, it will affect the rate of the corrosion. Corrosion will be more faster, or corrosion will take place there. If water is not there, dry air always is there, no corrosion will take place. So if water is there, then only corrosion takes place. Next is presence of the acid forming gases like carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, hydrogen sulfide. All these are the pollutants. All these cause pollution in the air. So if air is polluted, then basically we can say it will lead to the chemical action on the metal and corrosion will take place. Fourth point now, the presence of the salts, like different salts are there in the sea water. So if the ship that is made up of metal, it will corrode easily. Ship has to move in the sea water only, and sea water is salty. So salt present in that water will facilitate the corrosion. So next thing we'll see here, corrosion is observed much greater degree in the coastal area than in the places far away from the sea. Why is it so? Because in the coastal area, that water, the water of the sea or the ocean is salty water. That is why in the coastal area corrosion is more, because of that salt, presence of the salts only. Now we'll come to the the corrosion of the rusting. In the case of the corrosion of the iron, that is called as rusting. What is it? Rust is what? It is a reddish brown deposit on the surface of the iron object. If iron object has got rusted, you can see in this photograph, this key is having a reddish color deposit. This red deposit that is present here, the red deposit that is present is called as rust. This reddish deposit is because of the rust, called as iron oxide. The chemical name is iron second oxide. Iron second oxide is a chemical name of the rust. We will see all this here. The formula is also written. So rust is what? It is Fe2O3.xH2O, iron oxide. What is the value of X? XH2O means the number of water. XH2O is indicating the number of water molecule is not fixed. We have written X there. X can be 1, 2, 3, any of the natural numbers can be there. It depends on the amount of the water vapor in the air. If more water vapor, then more water will be there. It can be 10 also. If less water, then it can be less. It can be 1 or 2. It cannot be 0. It has to be between 1 and infinite. It depends on the upper limit is not here. So that is what about rusting. We have seen the definition and the chemical name you have to learn. Next, now metal oxide and the hydroxide are all bases, and they turn the moist red litmus paper into the blue, and so does rust. All the basic substances are generally rusting only. So this is now we will see a particular experiment that rusting takes place always in which kind of situation. So here they have given that situation, that is in moist air. In dry air it will not take place. If only water is there, if no air is there, then also it will not take place. So rusting takes place in moist air. Moist means water is there, air contains oxygen is there. Two factors are required there: presence of water, presence of air. Both are present in the moist air. If either air or moisture is absent, rust does not form. If oxygen is not there, then no rusting. If moisture or water vapor is not there, then also no rusting. So both the condition are required here. Let us see one of the experiments to prove this thing. You have to take three test tube and label them as A, B and C, and a few unrusted, neat and clean, small iron nails of similar size. Okay, so we have taken three test tube. We can see in this diagram, and three test tubes have been labeled as A, B and C. In all the test tube, we can see iron nails are present. All of them are unrusted. No one has been rusted. Next thing what we have to do, some of the nails we will put in the test tube A and put some tap water in it. Place A test tube in the stand. Test tube we have taken, and in that we have put some iron nails in the test tube A, and some water is there. Only water is there, nothing else is there. Test tube is open also, so that outside air can enter here. Next, now test tube B, what we'll see, let us read the second point. Distilled water. Distilled means pure water in the test tube B, and remove the dissolved air. So what we have to do? We have to boil this water. Boil some distilled water. When we are boiling this water, what will happen? Whatever air is dissolved in the water, some oxygen is dissolved in the water, it will move outside. So we will take some water, put some iron nails in that water, in the test tube, and boil it. On boiling, dissolved air, dissolved oxygen will move out of the water where this iron nail is present. Next thing what we will do, put the nails in the air free water and pour some oil above this. Oil will do what? Oil will not allow the water to come in contact with air. Just now we have removed the air by boiling. So because we have removed the air, and in case that air come back again, our boiling will be useless. So just to prevent the dissolving of the air back again, we are putting some oil there, and then we have to cork, place it in the stand. Cork is used to close the test tube. So you can see this diagram now. B part, boiled distilled water, that is air free, air is not there in this water. Next, oil is there. Oil is to what? Oil is to separate air and water, to separate air and water only. And upside what we have taken, this is the cork. What it will do? It will prevent air from entering test tube. So this is what is the function of this cork. Next, now C part test tube, will see in the third point. Place some quicklime, that is calcium oxide, in test tube C, and put few nails in the test tube. Cork it. Place the test tube in the test tube stand. Why we have taken quicklime now? Let us read here. Quicklime is having the ability to absorb all the moisture within the closed space. Thus, air in the test tube C does not contain any moisture. So here now, quicklime we have taken. In this test tube, air is there. And when we have taken this quicklime, air contains water also. Air is containing water. But because of this quicklime, what this quicklime will do? Quicklime will absorb this. Whatever water is present in the air, quicklime will absorb this. Now this air is not having any water vapor. And the air converts into what? Dry air. Air has converted into the dry air because quicklime has absorbed the water vapor or the water quantity or whatever moisture is there in the air. So that is the purpose of using this. Upside you can see here again cork is present. What is the purpose of the cork? Same thing, that is cork is cork do what? It prevents water to enter. It prevents water to enter inside the test tube. So that is all about the three test tube we have seen. Now what will be the observation? Examine the nails after a few days. Okay, we have kept the setup ABC of a test tube. We have kept in the test tube stand for a few days. After a few days, we will observe. Because rusting is a slow process, it takes some time. So we have to keep for a few days. After a few days, you'll see that only the nails in the test tube A have rusted and not in the others. Only test tube A rusting has taken place. Test tube B, no rusting. Test tube C also no rusting. What is the reason? The reason is simple. This is because test tube A has both air and moisture. Both the things are available there. In the case of the test tube B, iron does not rust. Why? Because moisture is there, but air is not going. You can see here, test tube B, water is there. Water is present. Air, where is the air? Air is upside here. And in between, you can see oil is there. Air is not moving into the water because of this oil. Oil is preventing the air to enter inside. And that is why, because of the absence of air, air is not there. That is why rusting does not take place in the test tube C. Next, now about the C. What is about the C they have written? That is air without moisture. Air without moisture, that is test tube C. Let us see here. Test tube, quicklime is there. And quicklime has done what? It has absorbed water. And because water is not there, test tube C will not have rusting. In the test tube C, two situations we will see here. Water is not there. Air is present. Out of these two things, only one is there. That is why rusting will not take place. In the test tube B, water is there, but air is not there. So again, rusting will not take place. In the test tube first one, that is A part, water is there or not? You can see the test tube. In the test tube, iron nails are there in the ordinary water. So water is there, yes. Air is coming. You can see we have not closed the test tube, so air can easily enter inside. So air also is there. Both the things are available, air as well as water. Air, whenever I am speaking, air means oxygen only. So oxygen and water both are available. That is why what? Rusting will take place. So what we learn by this experiment, simple learning is there, that rusting only and only take place in the presence of what? It takes place in the presence of water and oxygen. Both the things are required. So finally, what we conclude here is the chemical equation. Iron plus oxygen plus water. Iron need two things for rusting. One is oxygen, second one is water. If both are present, then iron will convert into what? It will convert into rust, that is a reddish brown deposit of iron oxide. Iron oxide will deposit, Fe2O3.xH2O will deposit here. What is it? Fe2O3. Fe2O3.xH2O. This is the formula of rust. This will deposit on what? On the object of iron. So that is all about rusting. How we can prevent it? Because it is a destructive process. So it is eating away the metal. It destroys the strength of the metal and metal will crack and the object will fall down. So that is why it is a highly destructive process or a chemical reaction. So if the metal is corroded, it has to be replaced and causes a lot of loss of the money because we have to purchase new substance then. So we can protect the metal. We can prevent the metal by rusting. How we can do? By preventing them from remaining in direct contact with air. We have to separate the contact of the metal with the air. Air should not contact this metal so that rusting does not take place or corrosion does not take place. For separating this metal from the air, we have method called as painting. That is the first method. One by one, let us see all of these. Painting. Applying a paint preferably acid resistant paint. It will protect the metal from the chemical action of the air. So painting will form a layer on the metal and it will not rust. Next is greasing. Greasing is done in the machine parts. Regular greasing has to be done so that the parts of the machine in the vehicles also, in different machines, it is done so that rusting does not take place there. Next is galvanizing. Galvanization is what? Metal object is dipped in a molten zinc. It is an industrial process. And as a result, what will happen? A layer of zinc forms on the surface of the metal. And as a result, finally, the metal of the or the particular object is said to be galvanized. Galvanizing will prevent the rusting. Example is galvanized iron. Galvanized iron pipes, GI pipes, are used for making the wire water connection. Normal iron, if we are using for making pipe, water pipe, it will rust after a few years. We will have to replace that water pipe. Because of the rusting, that pipe will be broken. So in place of the normal iron pipe, we are using GI pipes, galvanized iron pipes. Galvanization is done by which metal? Using zinc. Don't forget this zinc. Next is GI sheets are also used in the air coolers. Air coolers we are using, obviously water we are using, so that is also galvanized iron only. Galvanization done with help of zinc. Next is tinning. Tinning of metal is also done here. What is used? Tin metal we are using. Tin metal is deposited on iron. It will prevent the iron from rusting and also metal will start shining. It will give a good look to that particular sheet. Next is electroplating. In the presence of electricity, if we are depositing a thin layer of one metal on other metal by the electrolysis, in presence of electricity, it is called as electroplating. Example, we can electroplate a metal with tin, nickel, chromium, or copper. So any of these, out of these four, any one metal layer we can form. We can form the layer of tin or copper or chromium or anything else. Anything else we can use here on a particular object made of iron or any metal which is having rusting. So we can prevent the corrosion by this method. Electroplated metal also remain lustrous for a long period. Example, we will see here, nickel plated steel. It is used for making some parts of the cycle. The ringing of the bell, the ringing bell, that is actually nickel plated steel only. Next example is chrome plated steel. Brass is also used for bathroom fittings. All the taps and all in the bathroom, they are also electroplated. Chrome plated ones you can see in the utensils, copper plated ones. So that is all different ones, different examples of the electroplating we have covered. Final step is to prevent the rusting or corrosion is alloying. Alloying the metal with other metal means mixing the different metals and non-metal produces alloy. And because of the making of the alloy, we can prevent the corrosion or rusting also. Examples like stainless steel, it contains iron. Iron will have rusting. So we are mixing different things, iron, chromium, nickel, manganese, and carbon. All these will form what? Stainless steel, and we can use stainless steel. Utilize utensils in the kitchen are made of stainless steel only. Next is brass. It is made by copper and zinc. Bronze made by copper and tin. Magnesium made up of aluminium, magnesium, and copper. So all these are mixtures of metal. When we are mixing different metals, alloy will form, and alloy do not have rusting. All these are corrosion resistant. So these are different steps how we can prevent the corrosion. First is painting, grease. Second, greasing. Third is galvanizing. Fourth is tinning. Five is electroplating, and sixth one is alloying. These are the various steps about preventing the corrosion. I hope it is clear to everyone. Still any doubt from this chapter, as it is over, you can post your queries or doubts in the comment section below, or you can send the message in the personal chat on the Teams app as well. You will have one more video in the upcoming part that will be the exercise of this chapter. That is all for this video. Thank you for now.